Welcome to Fallout 4. This is the second episode of the Let's Play. I'm going to be a little bit out of character here in the beginning of this one. As I want to go over some of the things, because I know anybody who watched the first one probably were scratching their head and screaming at the screen, "Please don't make your special like that!" And all that stuff. But since Fallout 3, there has been, at the end of every vault, like when you first step out, there has been a chance to remake your character. And that's what we are doing here. And I will explain to you exactly what I am doing, why I'm making those changes, because I have a little bit of a roleplay, you know, background here, which I have like a couple reasons why I want to do certain specials in certain ways and whatnot. And also, after we have left the vault, I want to give you my game plan before I get going. Of what I'm going to be doing in this world. Because this is not a blind let's play. I have prior knowledge to the game. I will try to keep that to the minimum though. And I will try to play the game in such a way as I've almost never experienced it. So, I should be fairly good with that. Anyway. Firstly, we will be changing appearance. At this point, we are changing the appearance of the character. And there is a good reasoning for that. I'm gonna keep the hairstyle, I'm gonna keep all of this as it is. However, there are a couple changes I want to make. Firstly, we are changing eye color. Where was that? There we go. That is going to be our eye color, alright? And I think we might change hair color to something a little, you know, like, I don't want to go bleached. Do we want to change hair color? I think I kind of like the chestnut brown. The eye color was the main thing. Hair color I was considering whether I want to, and I think we are going to keep it. Alright. That is done. Now, special attributes. Name is gonna stay as it is. However, we're gonna drop perception by 1, down to 2, and endurance down to 1. The perception, this relates to the eye color change. I imagined in such a way that the when the character got refrozen, like you came out of the cryogenic freezing when the bad guys came and got refrozen, something went wrong with that refreezing and the eyes got damaged. So essentially can still see but don't see quite as well. And so eye colors changed, eyes are now more milky, and perception went down. Also, have been a long time in cryogenic freezing, so endurance is gonna go down. It's like, I've been, well, a long time in cryogenic freezing, essentially. Also, charisma is gonna go down a little bit, because not everything, like, the way you are used to behaving prior to the war, doesn't necessarily translate to the post-nuclear wasteland the same way. Not everybody is gonna come out and, you know, want to shake your hand in a friendly or have a, you know, casual chit-chat at a street corner and so forth. People are going to behave differently. Same way, same reason intelligence is gonna go down by 1. While for many people in the, you know, post-nuclear world, somebody with this much intelligence, who's a law degree and whatnot, might seem really intelligent, but their intelligence, what they knew of the world from before war, before the explosions, doesn't necessarily translate that well to the post-nuclear world. Don't necessarily know what the heck has changed, and so forth. I am going to compensate that by increasing agility a couple points. Manual dexterity has, well, this doesn't make sense to do the, you know, a manual dexterity increase at this point, but I'll just roll with it. And this stat has to go up, because, come on, survived the nuclear holocaust. The only survivor out of a vault where everybody else got killed, essentially. Not 10 luck, though, because well, did lose husband, and kid got taken, so not that lucky, but lucky enough to make it out as the sole survivor out of the vault. Alright, I think that is it, that has to be it, we are done. No roleplay for this, this is a gameplay decision, this Agility 5. Everything else, as you can imagine though, is basically a roleplay. Roleplay, but it still plays into the actual gameplay plan. And accept. We are done. Double checking that everything got correct. Yes, and eyes are still white. And let us leave.
Enjoy your return to the surface. And thank you for choosing Vault-Tec.
That was sarcasm. I am enjoying my return to the surface. Alright, now we are out, and before I get any further, before I go back in character and start wandering around the wasteland, plan. Game plan. Let's show it off. My game plan here. Alright, so game plan is to, well, have a whole lot of agility, a whole lot of luck. This is going to be VATS playthrough. I have actually played very little VATS. The shooting mechanics in the game have gotten pretty damn awesome since Fallout 3 days. So I didn't really play around with VATS much before. Now I'm going to do that. I'm going to do rifle VATS, which is Y2 perception for Rifleman. So I'm going to do rifle VATS, and I'm going to try to stick to like low-tech weaponry, essentially, like no lasers, no plasma, or things like of that sort. I'm going to try to stay with the ballistic rifles and all that good stuff. Probably something like hunting rifle or something for most of the game. For most of the game. This 4 charisma was kind of a coincidence. I didn't want to go all the way down charisma, but I might run around actually with attack dog. I might get the dog and use the dog as my main companion for mostly. We will not have access to lockpicking, but I'm going to take hacker. It kind of makes roleplay sense that somebody who has a law degree and who has been from prior to the war, like from before the war, actually knows something about computers, but would have no clue whatsoever on how to, you know, crack safes open and all that stuff. The 5 agility coincides with action girl, that's essentially what we want for VATS play. And I do want an extra point of luck for a 4-leaf clover, and then we are going to do this stuff. I will not be taking idiot savant, I just believe it does not fit the character, like, at all. So, I will not be taking idiot savant at all here. Another thing, I have a 4 gameplay plan. I like making characters with weaknesses, and so we will, well, go into substance abuse. Not drugs, this is a character after all who has law degree from prior, from, you know, before the bombs fell and all that stuff. So, no drugs. However, we will be swilling alcohol. And since, I will show that off as well, in case you are not familiar with the Fallout 4 system. There would be a party girl park here, which, like, there is no chance you'll get addicted to alcohol and all that good stuff. However, I will not be taking this. I will not be taking this because, well, firstly, we don't have access to this, but also I do want to have the alcohol addiction itself to contend with. So we will have an alcohol addiction. Very well. I think that is everything. Game plan and character plan and the reasons for this character plan. Hopefully that is enjoyable for you as an idea. If not, well, there are other Let's Plays you may watch. Now, back into the character, let's start exploring the wasteland. Okay. Lots of dead people right outside. These are probably operators or people who managed to not get in just before the bomb, like, or when the bombs fell. Nuka-Cola. Nice. All over that before the war. Probably very nice now still as well. 8-ball yardstick. That is the elevator push button. That opens the elevator door. Right away. Kickball. Handcuffs. Okay. Handcuffs. Anything else here? Anything? Does not appear so. Are those propane tanks? Propane balls? Gosh. Some kind of a welding gear balls all over the place. Uh-huh. Anything else? That's Sanctuary Hills down there. Yeah, that's where we... yeah, this is the slope where we came up. Alright. Pre-war. A bottle cap. That is one of those things which I do not understand. How does your character know at the beginning of a game that bottle cap is the money for this particular world already? No idea. Right. Anything interesting this way? I'm sorry, you got your head smashed by a car door and probably died. That doesn't seem like fun, does it? Okay. Doesn't seem like there's nothing here. On this side, huh? Nope. Seems kind of empty. Hub flower. Hub flower, okay. Hub? Okay. Well, it is something at least. Why is that? Wild carrots. Well, food. Food it is. Food it is. Oh, speaking of which. Ten millimeter gets to go, like, I don't know, here? Let's put the baton on the... on here as well. Like somewhere around there, and... I might do steam packs as well. Here. Did I just take a steam pack? I think I just took a steam pack. Yeah, well. Bottles. Nuka-Cola bottles, beer bottles. Alright. Alright. Oh, no. I dropped the steam pack. Ha! Right. Also dropped the 10mm pistol. Do I wanna even find that? I probably should find that thing, because it might be useful for selling later. But it doesn't matter that much. So, accidentally dropped my pistol. Or one of the two pistols. I still have a pistol, right? Yes, I still have a pistol. Oh. Eh, cool. Whatever. Let's pick it up. Because I just saw it. Alright. Let us keep our guns handy. Never know what all can come across. Oh, I am so sorry about all of this. Poor people got blown up. Blown up. Silt bean. Is that a different kind of bean? Like a silt bean? What's that? Wild gourd blossom. Can those be eaten? Probably. Food, water, important things. Yep. Okay. Okay. Let's go down here. Another hub of flower. Uh-huh. Water. This is probably... yeah, radioactive water. I do admit I like what they did with the changes to the game. A little bit out of character talk here. Like, you can actually walk around in this kind of shallow water without getting irradiated, unlike many of the previous games. That is actually very, very nice. And also, while I am at it, before I get to Sanctuary and start doing some actual combat and stuff, a reminder to everybody, if you did not watch my intro video to this particular Let's Play, this will be on very easy difficulty. If you want to know why, go watch the intro video. That's all there is to it. Okay. So that's blocking Sanctuary. We are home. This is also where I'm going to use a prior game knowledge just a bit to make things a little bit easier on myself. Did you see that shot? I am a sniper. I am a marksman with this thing. There's, the other one is on my right, right? Ha ha. I squished the bugs. Then I take bubble gum. Oh, Nuka Cola. Nice. I will be looting up Sanctuary Hills. I actually... a little bit extra talk. I actually have no idea if I want to play the settlement part of the game at all. Do, if somebody's watching this, do let me know, do you want to see like separate videos where I do settlement building? There is some settlement building I will definitely do, but it is going to be very minor for the most part, because I do not magic travel, as in I do not fast travel. Instead I'm using a mod which allows me to build like a vehicle, which allows me to travel from settlement to settlement, but no other targets can be done. Or can be traveled to, only between settlements. And that is what I'm going to do with my fast travel. I will not be fast traveling from location to location. I will be using my settlements to facilitate that travel. And it will also take some materials as well, because those vehicles require fuel to be operated. So, alright. Let us continue. Okay, I see you there, you buzzing little creature. I see you. Now, if I can land a shot on you without... I see the other one's wings buzzing there, but I don't think I have that shot. Yeah, I don't. Okay, can I... These things are annoying to hit. They flitter around like crazies. I actually have that shot. Alright. As mentioned previously, the game's combat system has gotten so much better from Fallout 3. And also to an extent Fallout 4. Fallout New Vegas. Fallout New Vegas was already pretty good. But yeah, this is so good. I didn't need VATS on my... the first time I played the game. Alright. Plastic pumpkin. Baby rattle, That is a safe. Do I even have bobby pins yet? I might have one bobby pin? Maybe. Maybe I have a one bobby pin, but that is not in any hurry to get. 10mm pistol. Nice. Nice. Very nice. Extra pistols. Extra pistols I can either scrap or sell. Break apart. Do things with. That is always good to have extras. Let's see what else can we find. Swap the weapon. Flip lighters. Cigarette boxes. Bottles. Very nice to have bottles. Bottles are good. Extinguisher. Cap stash. Okay, now we have bobby pins, that's for sure. That is for sure we have bobby pins. Postman uniform. Oh, cool. We have another set of clothes we can get out of this vault jumpsuit. Because I don't want to be wearing a vault jumpsuit after what was revealed to us that the Voltec has been essentially doing experimentation on unknowing humans. So we will be using something else. Granite cap and a postman uniform. Does that look? That doesn't look overly bad. We're gonna go with that. You're gonna go with it. Okay. What else was here? Dog bowl. No, I raided the fridge of this place already. Anything else here that I should be aware of? Mirror is empty. Dresser. I will open the saves at another time. Right now I first just want to do a quick look at things and also speak with my robot. Speak with the robot. This is the foreknowledge sort of thing. If you clear those bugs from the house and the other house first, essentially you explore the houses, you don't have to do that with the robot. Otherwise you have to. There is something little for you to know in case you didn't know that about the game.
As I live and breathe! Oh, it's really you!
Did they build artificial lungs on you so you actually breathe? I don't think they did.
Codsworth, what happened to the world?
The world, Mum? Well, besides our geranium still being the envy of Sanctuary Hills, I'm afraid things have been dreadfully dull around here. Things will be so much more exciting with you and Sir back. Where is your better half, by the by?
They killed him.
Oh, Mum, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Oh, Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Wait, have we been playing charades or checkers with Sean already? At that age, probably would eat the game instead of playing it.
He's gone, god damn it. Someone took him. They stole my baby.
It's worse than I thought. Mm-hmm. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
200 years? What? Are you sure?
A bit over 210, actually, Mum. Give or take a little for the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack. You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little weird. What's wrong?
Mom, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car! The car! How do you polish rust?
What do you know, Codsworth?
I'm afraid I don't know anything, Mum. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe Sir was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
Thank you, Codsworth.
You're welcome. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? Sir and young Sean may turn up yet.
Codsworth, I already looked. They're not here.
Then they're really gone, aren't they? Oh, Mom.
Thanks for trying, Codsworth.
You can't give up, Mum. What about the city? Concord is nearby, and, well, the people there have only shot at me a few times.
There's still people alive in Concord?
Yes, although they're a bit rough. You remember the way? Just across the southern footbridge, out of the neighborhood, and past the Red Rocket Station?
I shall remain here and secure the home front.
Yes, you do that. You do that. So, essentially, you haven't had anybody to whine at for 200 years. Alright. I'll take that as a good sign then. Yellow table lamp. Fantastic. American flags.
There we go.
Yay. Also, please let me know if the color of my HUD and Pip-Boy are annoying. I happen to prefer this sort of a muted color myself, but I can change them if it's annoying people. Salt shaker, the usual Fallout. I mean, Fallout has always been about loot. Let's close the fridge. We left it closed when we left. You know what? We probably don't need to call the repairman anymore. Also, get more sugar bombs. That might be a good idea. Mr. Handy Fuel. Is this how you have been keeping yourself fueled all these years? 200 years or whatever what it was? 210? Wait, we had bobby pins and Radaway in our mirror. Bobby pins in our mirror? That has to be some kind of a sick joke by the husband.
I'm coming, sweetheart.
Okay, let's grab some wooden blocks and a board game. Toy car. Okay, this is where we are picking a point of luck. Now we are even more lucky. Pompadour wig. Interesting. Picture frame. Okay, interesting. How would we look with a pompadour wig? No, thank you. Let's stick to cap. Cap gives luck. Eyeglasses. I do believe I want sunglasses to try and hide those milky eyes from people, so nobody like really stares all that much. Anybody home? Anybody? Nope. Nobody's home. Okay. Caps. Bottle caps. Aha. Oh. A tin can in the fridge, another bottle. Bottles. Desk fan. Always good to have more things you can sell when you... Oh, is it a dress? It is a dress. Okay, okay. Anything in here? No. Another postman uniform. All right, I have those things on form now. Excuse the bad joke. You know what? I see you there. I see you. And I missed. And I utterly missed. Oh, another bottle. Wait, more of you things? Go away, thank you. Go away. Oh, a cigar. Fantastic. Nuka cherry. Yum yum deviled eggs. Whoever makes and markets something called devil is kind of weird person.
Sweet.
Also, reminder to folks that I am indeed using a mod, which, like, out of character knowledge, in case you did not watch my intro video, I am indeed using a mod which changes the lockpicking sweet spot to always be at the middle, and changing the hacking minigame so that there is always only the correct password around. Reasons for all of that? Because those minigames are not fun, they are just a useless time sink. They could have innovated on them, but there has been no innovation on either of them, essentially, since Fallout 3. They are essentially nothing but artificial game lengthening, and in Fallout 4 you cannot even be entirely locked out of a terminal. They just put a little bit of a time delay there and then you can retry. No reason whatsoever to try and enjoy them, because they are not very enjoyable. Oh, fertilizer. Fertilizer. Very good. No monsters. Kitchen scale. Loot the world. No mirror with bobby pins? Nope. No mirror with bobby pins. Nothing else here either, it seems like. Aha! I see you there! Scrap detention trigger too, huh? Okay, unlock the safe. What is in the safe? 10mm pistol, yet another one! Nice! And indeed there is, as mentioned, only one choice.
There we go.
Okay. Terminal. Let's check up on who is doing what. Wait. Somebody has been keeping an eye on the neighbors? Right? This is from before the war, right? This is from before the war, right? Okay. Ledger terminal. Okay. Di Pietro. Totally high strung and needs to relax. I keep telling him that. Offering to help. By the looks of the guy, he's self-medicating with pie. He's a pie eater? Is that a bad thing? Rosa. Heard some buff out. Okay, so you are a drug seller of some sort. Favorite tin hole hat. Guess he's a one-a-day kind of guy. 7 ampules of day tripper a week. Okay. Interesting. Something called Psycho. And if it does, do I really want this Neanderthal using it? Some feels army connections. Yeah, wasn't Psycho the army made drug in this world? Excel. Excel. Okay, interesting name for a drug. Going to have words about more than money. Master bedroom under the dresser. There is a safe. Nice. Okay. Concord. Concord. Daddy O. Is that a drug? Really? Daddy O. Pseudo intellectual asshole. Okay. Money is good. Well, that usually. Medex. Some kind of a long-term pain management going. Anders. Usually a no-go, but this girl's got style and she's not interested in getting tweaked. 20 blood packs. Maybe she's really a vampire. Okay. So, vampires. Boston. Okay. Student at CIT wants Day Tripper XL and entire palette of mentats. Crazy Expert definitely sounds like it. And what's a palette of mentats? I have no idea. No idea what's a palette of mentats. Good for a couple Day Tripper per week. Easy order, cool people, no brainer. Alright. McDermott Cop. Buff out customer cop. Running into supply problems. Low budding, if he can't get what he wants. Yes, well, obviously that's why you don't sell to cops. Upter Daddy-O order. Weird but profitable. Okay. Miscellaneous. Potential in Charlestown. Medex. Underwear model. Underwear model? Wanted the steam packs. Okay. Don't want to even know. Alright. Alright. Another dress. Is it a dress? Oh. Okay. Medex. Okay. Drug dealer has drugs in his house. Obviously. And the chemist workbench and the backyard. That makes sense. Like, obviously. A wrench. Alright. You know what? Don't come out of your hiding if you don't wanna die. Haha! 0.38 rounds. Damn these bugs. Damn these bugs. Okay. Loot up the place. Anything that is not nailed down is coming with me. Maybe everything that is nailed down. Another bottle of milk. Aha. Mirror. Mirror, mirror, tell me what is going on. Haha, there is the safe.
Locked tight.
Damn, too tight of a safe. Cannot do. Oh well, oh well. So what else is here? What else is here? Trash... Trash can with fragmentation grenades. Who has been doing what here? What? What is going on? There is also... Also something here that I will grab and then go back to Sanctuary Hills. That is to say... Oh, a double barrel shotgun. That's a nice weapon to find here. But... In case most people miss it, there is actually a duffel bag. A duffel bag. Alright. Grab those guns, come back to Sanctuary Hills. Because there are a couple nooks and crannies, couple things I want to do before I end this particular episode. In Sanctuary Hills to make note of. First aid box right here, and then I'm going to give a little bit of a crafting tip of sorts. Also, there was Cram doesn't sell for much, but in the very early game, it's very much worth that. You know what we are doing right now, because we managed to freaking find some Quinet Brew. We're gonna start swigging that alcohol, because we're gonna be an alcoholic. starts right now. Makeshift battery, a shovel, oh, adjustable wrench. That is nice. Anything in this house? Coffee pot and a used oil can. Very, very nice. We had those. Oh, steam pack and a radaway. Fantastic. We had those couple safes to open. Casual outfit. Casual outfit. Might wanna have a look-see on how this stuff actually looks. Maybe? Maybe we will do just that here. In the rain. How does this stuff look? Casual outfit. Oh, this is the one from pre-war. And how about this? Okay, might use drifter outfit for now. Look a little bit more like a scavenger, you know, than the postman. Yeah, it has a little bit of resistances on it too. So yeah, let's look a little bit more like a proper wastelander. Crack those safes I found earlier, but before doing that, visit the cellar, root cellar, which is in Sanctuary Hills. Because this is a one of those places you really want to go to if you want to be able to afford things early on in the game. Because gold bars can be nice for crafting, nice and necessary, and also I cannot craft this safe. So, there is that. More bobby pins, but also booze to fuel our alcohol addiction. Or, well, not an addiction yet because we didn't get addicted, but it will eventually be an alcohol addiction. Nice. Thank you for that. Thank you for that. All right. Now, where were those two safes? The two houses passed by, had a safe in them. Had safes in them. Also, might want to stop by these banks, because there is usually something in mailboxes, right? Mailboxes tend to have things. There is the one safe right here. Let's open that.
That's it.
Another 10mm. Oh my gosh, I have a stash of those things now. That might actually be a good thing. Might be a really good thing. To have a stash of 10mm pistols even. Very nice. Did I think I cleaned this house up anyway. Believe I did. Yes. I cleaned, utterly cleaned this house. Okay. Nice. This is another little home here with a safe. Open that safe.
Nice.
Meant that psycho pipe pistol. Pre-war money. Lots of pre-war money and shotgun shells. Nice. Very nice. Okay, there goes my booze. It has worn off. Don't need more at the moment, I don't think. We will become a heavy drinker eventually, but not just yet. Oh, right. Let us use the work workshop. Let's leave the sign intact. I will show something quite actually can get rid of these things because they are like on the way. They are blocking the walk path. Let's destroy those then. Scrap the house. Another thing I want to scrap is this doghouse. Also can scrap that. It's one of those little things. If you want to send your dog to Sanctuary Hills, the Sanctuary Hills has 3 doghouses to begin with. And don't mind that message, it's from a mod which helps cleaning out the various corpses, which is kind of nifty actually. So, as mentioned, where is the other one? No, right, it was behind this house here. So, here we go. So, if you destroy the dog houses, or two of them at least, then you grab the third dog house and put that dog house where you want the dog to actually be at. You can move the dog exactly where you want the dog to be at. Like so. I think I'm going to destroy, scrap this car and leave the dog house right here. Yeah, now the dog will be hanging around that dog house. Ain't that nice? Another thing, why did I take that out? Another thing I'm going to do before I end this video. Although I'm scrapping a couple things here, is to move the crafting stations finally, because I do want them in nice convenient place. Also clean up the place just a little bit, get rid of some of the things which are on the walking path, you know. Okay, so there is the cooking station. You can be around here. Nice. Then we will go grab another station. So, scrap that stuff. Scrap the stuff from back here. The chemistry station. Put that up there as well. Move all of them on this little platform here. Then I nicely have all of them in one location, which I have easy access to. Scrap the branches, so there is no stuff in my walking. On my way when I walk between the various places, so I'm gonna scrap some tires. Gonna grab the weapons workbench. I am aware I could actually, you know, put these things, the different workbenches, like, store them into the workshop itself. And then just, you know, replant all of them. But I just like moving them manually like this. It takes a little bit more time and stuff, but yeah. It's kind of nice. Feels like you're organizing things for your own amusement and so forth, so. I'm doing it this way around. Anyways, put this here too. Why the heck not? Alright. Alright, all that stuff is now in place. Fantastic and absolutely fabulous. Let's grab some concrete. We're gonna need concrete if we're gonna start building stuff. Also, speaking of random things, I'm going to make myself a sleeping bag, like right here. A sleeping bag and some kind of a container I can, you know, put things into. Do I have a very basic wooden box? Right? Like that. Alright, cool. See? All is well. I'm going to cook the meat and do all of that stuff. Off camera, I'm not gonna bother you folks any longer here. I will see you next time.